What's going on, y'all? If you're looking for today's Miami Dolphins news and rumors, you are in the right place. Mitchell Renz from Chat Sports, and we have some interesting stories to break down on today's show. We're going to talk about Tua. I got some MVP odds as well. We're also going to break down Ryan Fitzpatrick and the potential to sign free agent running back Aaron Jones. We're going to kick this show off first, though, as I had a nice little whistle there around Tua. And according to Field Yates, he went on, you know, to write an article about trying to predict every starting quarterback in 2021. I'll be honest with y'all, I have also done this video here at Chat Sports. It's a really fun and entertaining one. He projected the Dolphins starter to be Tua, which, sure, I don't really think is that big of a surprise. However, with the amount of trade rumors that have been linked to not only him, but also other quarterbacks like a Deshaun Watson, and any single time we get a new update around Watson, what's one of the main teams that's always connected? It's Tua. So what I wanted to be able to do here is give you guys an update, because I'm also starting to believe more and more that Tua is going to be the starting quarterback for this Miami Dolphins football team in 2021. But here's what Field Yates had to say on the Dolphins sticking with him until Deshaun Watson is traded. Many people will link Miami as a most logical suitor. For now, I believe Tua Tagovailoa returns as the starter with Miami instead of focusing on surrounding him with elevated talent to allow him to grow. After all, he's just a year removed from being the number 5 overall pick in the NFL draft. Here's the second part of that. Tua had his moments as a rookie starter, and he has plenty of natural tools which work for him. Ultimately, he'll face unique expectations given his draft status, but year 2 should look much better. So what do we do here at Chat Sports? We talk about the latest news and rumors, but we also debate it, because that's what family does. Sometimes you have difficult conversations that get people upset, but I'll be honest with y'all, I love the difficult conversations, because that's how you really get to know people and what they're thinking. So be honest with me here. Do you want Tua as the starting quarterback? Type Y for yes, or I want you to type N for no. Let's look at Tua and what he did in the 10 games back in 2020. Technically, I'm going to say like 9 games, because in the one, it was like at the very, very end where he had 2-for-2 completions, garbage time. But 1,814 yards, 11 touchdowns, 5 interceptions. But what I really want you to look at here is this bit of a split. His first 4 starts compared to his last 5 games. Yes, it's not quite starts to games, but here, this is where we're going. The first 4 starts, 61.1% completion percentage. 593 yards, 6 touchdowns, 0 picks, but that 3-1 record. But then you also look at his last 5 games, more yards, more picks, less touchdowns, worse record, higher completion percentage. And the hardest part is figuring out which Tua you're going to be able to get, because there was definitely glimpses in those first 4 starts where you're like, wow, this kid might actually be everything he's cracked up to be, and that's one of the reasons why a lot of people were excited that Miami Dolphins went out and drafted him at number 5. But then you also saw the downsides, and I understand that 3-2 record, if it wasn't for Ryan Fitzpatrick coming in and saving the day against the Las Vegas Raiders, that record would look a little bit different, probably 2-3. So I found these odds here, which from BetUS, today's sponsor, and right now they have Tua as plus 5,000 odds to win. That's the 18th highest odds to win the NFL MVP. So what I want you to be able to do here is, if you are really confident that Tua is the guy, why not put your money where your mouth is? So go to chatsports.com/bet. Promo code Dolphins125. It gets you 125% deposit bonus. So if you get started with BetUS, you deposit $100, you get $125 for free to bet with. Why not use that $125 for free that you got to go bet some money on Tua winning the NFL MVP? I mean, if it's free money, roll the dice. So with plus 5,000 odds, what does that mean exactly? It means if you put down $10 on Tua to win the MVP, and he wins it, you get $500. I mean, that sounds pretty good to me. You want to get even more ballsy? Put down $50. What could you have to lose? All I'm saying is, like, sometimes these are the type of bets that, sure, some people are like, wow, I don't know why anybody would do that. Lamar Jackson won the MVP his second year. Patrick Mahomes won the MVP his second year. Would it really be that crazy? I don't know. So here you go one more time, chatsports.com/bet. Promo code Dolphins125. It gets you 125% deposit bonus. And if you're one of the people that said, yeah, I am confident that Tua is going to be my quarterback, put your money where your mouth is. Let's see it. All right, let's go to the next story here. It's going to be around Ryan Fitzpatrick. And could the dude with the best beard in the National Football League be returning to Miami? So Pro Football Focus put out an article about the top 50 free agents and where they could potentially sign in this upcoming year. Fitz was projected to re-sign with the Miami Dolphins. The deal that PFF thought that made the most sense was 1 year, $10 million, and that $10 million was fully guaranteed. Is that a lot of money to pay for a backup quarterback? Yes, yes it is. In fact, last season, I believe the only team that paid a backup quarterback more than $10 million was actually technically the Las Vegas Raiders. It's also the Indianapolis Colts, who had Jacoby Brissett, but they also brought in Phillip Rivers. But in terms of knowing that you have a backup quarterback, I believe it was the Raiders with $10 million. But let's look at what Tua did in 10 games and what Ryan Fitzpatrick did in 9 games. Do I understand that there's not 19 games in a season? Of course. But so many times you saw Tua start a game, and then Fitz would come in. Or Fitz would be in a game, and then Tua would come in. It was almost like you had a starting pitcher and a relief pitcher every single game. Now, Fitz, I will say that I actually thought, in terms of numbers, played a lot better, and QBR definitely explains that. 52.9 for Tua, 77.3 for Fitz. Fitz actually finished top 5 in the NFL in terms of QBR, but I'll also say this. The offense was built, Chan Gailey's offense was built a lot more around Ryan Fitzpatrick. So here's a quote from PFF on Miami re-signing Ryan Fitzpatrick. Keeping Fitz around for another year to help guide Tua is a sensible step for the Dolphins to take. And in the event Fitz is needed on the field for Miami, he has proven he can make the team competitive, which I think you and I both agree is, you know, pretty reasonable here. So before I get to this next quote, I do want you all to remember that this is from Pro Football Focus. So let's look at this one real quick. Over the past 2 years, he ranks 18th in passing grade, okay, 7th in positively graded throw rate. Considering the Dolphins' low offensive line and average at best receiving unit, that's quite impressive, which, again, I agree with. And I was pretty excited to ultimately see Ryan Fitzpatrick and what he was able to do last year. And I am a believer that he did help Tua grow, and those two had a great relationship. So type your votes in here. Should the Miami Dolphins re-sign Ryan Fitzpatrick? Go down in the comments section on YouTube. Let me know. I want you to type R for re-sign or type LW for let walk. It's a tough one for me. I don't really know if I want to pay that much money for a backup quarterback, but it is at least curious. R for re-sign or LW for let walk. Now, I want to say congratulations, y'all, but technically, we didn't quite get there yet, but we're about to pass Lions Talk. Now, if you want to be the person that ends up doing the passes this other channel, please go ahead and do so. So for about a month, we've been trying to catch Detroit Lions Talk with Micro Mike, another channel here at Chat Sports. We're 3 away. We needed 84 new subs to catch them yesterday. Now, you only need 3 more. So if you haven't already subscribed to this YouTube channel, please do. Hit the big red button underneath here. And if you are one of the loyal subscribers, take that link that y'all see below, youtube.com/dolphinsnews, and send it to some friends because you guys are doing a hell of a job. All right, the last story here on today's show is around the potential of Miami signing top free agent running back Aaron Jones. Just like we talked about Fitz, I'm also going to take a deep dive into Pro Football Focus predicting Aaron Jones signing with the Miami Dolphins. Now, the projected deal that they have, which you can see at the bottom of the screen, 4 years, $46 million, $25 million guaranteed. I'll tell you what, is Aaron Jones worth that type of money? Maybe. And it's not, has nothing really to do with me not liking Jones. It's more of, I am not a fan of a lot of times paying a running back. However, if you can go out and get the best running back in free agency, it's at least something to think about. And a lot of times, if a guy does it for 1 year, you're like, okay, well, can he do it in back-to-back years? Yes, yes, Aaron Jones absolutely can. This was not a very highly touted running back in college. He wasn't a very highly touted running back when he came out of the draft. He just busted his butt and worked his way into a role. I mean, look at these numbers in 2019 and 2020. You're looking at a dude who's got 30 touchdowns over the last 2 seasons. Sure, the Packers' offense is good, but Aaron Jones really carried that offense in 2019. Aaron Rodgers, I'll say, was the bigger reason why his numbers, in terms of yards per carry, were a little bit better. Plus, in 2020, that was in 14 games. Now, is Aaron Jones an upgrade over all the running backs that the Miami Dolphins currently have? Yes, absolutely. No disrespect to Gaskin. No disrespect to Ahmad. However, if you can try to upgrade, that's what you should do, right? We'll get to that in a second. So here's why PFF thought Miami signing Jones made the most sense. Jones will likely encounter a slim market due to more NFL front offices recognizing the value or lack thereof the running back position. This is no disrespect to Jones, who is a great athlete and NFL running back, but his position simply doesn't stack up in terms of wins and losses on the football field. Second part of that quote, Miami is just one of the few teams that will have the cap space and be willing to sign Jones to a deal of this magnitude. They fielded one of the least efficient rushing attacks of the 2020 season, producing a minus 0.1 EPA per run, which ranked 28th in the National Football League. So go down in the comments section. Let me know that was PFF's thoughts on signing Aaron Jones. But no disrespect to them. I don't really care about them. I care about y'all. So should the Dolphins go out and sign Jones? Type S for sign, type P for pass. I know that we have talked about this multiple times on this show before, but the more and more Jones keeps getting linked, the more and more I feel like I need to talk about it. So S for sign, P for pass. I'm saying pass, man. Like, you don't go out and sign Aaron Jones. And again, it has nothing to do with him. He is a phenomenal athlete. I've actually gotten to know his younger brother, Alvin, who follows me on Twitter and says that, hey, Jones wants to be, you know, paid like a top running back. And I get that because it's not an easy position to do. However, if you can go out and get a running back in the draft, you should try to do that, especially if you're Miami. Like, you have picks 18, 36, and 50. If you want a top back, you can get a Najee Harris at 18. You can get a Travis Etienne, I think, at 36. Or you can get the running back from North Carolina, maybe even at pick number 50, right? Like, what was his name? Javonte Williams. Thank you, producer Sam, is escaping me, which for some reason can never remember his name. My point is this. You can save the money then at the running back position, because, I mean, you still got pretty good production. Plus, Eric Studsville, he's the new co-OC. I think he's going to rock and roll with some of the guys he has. If you guys disagree with me, hey, that's what the show is all about. One more time, hit that big red button before I leave, because we are about to catch Micro Mike. You guys have done a phenomenal job. I'm going to give you a round of applause.